I want to tell you one last story. It's the story of the Carnation evaporated milk. There's a factory in Modesto, California, right in the heart of the Central Valley, that is the only Carnation evaporated milk factory in North America. Here's how the factory works. They make 2 million cans of milk a day. To do that, they take in 400,000 gallons of raw milk. Wait for it. Here's the complicated process for making evaporated milk. They evaporate half the water out, and they can what's left. That's it. That's the process. They call the evaporated water milk water. They also buy 88 million, or have been buying 88 million gallons of water a year, 250,000 gallons of fresh water a day to run the factory. So in one part of the factory, they're evaporating 200,000 gallons of water a day, the milk water, and throwing it in the sewer, and paying, of course, to throw it in the sewer. At another part of the factory, they're paying to buy 250,000 gallons of water a day to run the factory. They're also paying to throw that away. In the middle of the drought, a guy named Bob Valdez, who is the chief engineer at the Carnation factory, said, "What in the world are we doing here?" That Carnation plant has now, if it hasn't become a zero water factory at this moment, it will in the next few months. They are going to use the water that they have been evaporating off the milk and throwing away to run the factory. Why not? By the way, it's called milk water, but it's actually pretty clean at the moment it flashes up off the milk, right? It's evaporate. They are gonna cut themselves off from the big pipe. In some places, that would be a financial disaster for the water utility. In Modesto, in the middle of the drought, the city and the community could not have been happier about this initiative. By the way, the people who work in that factory, they live in that town. They're not somewhere else. So that, to me, is obviously a brilliant example of smart water. Didn't require any. All it required was drawing the circle a little bigger.